Welcome to the Rusted Garden Homestead. Today's video is about how can you make, on a budget, practically free, your own seed starting cell so that you can start seeds indoors. This is basil made out of aluminum foil. I'm going to show you how to make this out of aluminum foil, and then I'm going to show you how you can repurpose plastic water bottles into something simple. And you know, this is pretty straightforward, cut it into pieces. But I want to show you how I stack these together using some tape so that they're not falling over all over the place. That was actually the hardest part, is figuring out how to use these, but in a way that they will stay in a container, they're not going to fall over. And if you want to subscribe, follow me. Starting in January, I restart my garden year, basically, and I'll teach you how to grow stuff indoors. So getting ready for January, some of the things you might want to do is pick up some foil baking trays. I actually got 30 of these from Costco. I think it was $9 or $10. You can recycle them. Basic aluminum foil. I recommend for this project the heavy duty variety. This is 12 inches long. That's about 30 centimeters. This is perfect for creating these types of containers. So, you know, you can even recycle aluminum foil as you're using it throughout the year. But heavy duty foil, couple foil trays, and you can grow just about anything you want indoors. And the beauty of this design is you can create the pockets as large as you want. The bigger the pockets, the less you have to pot up your plants. They grow bigger root systems, and it's a little bit easier for you because you're not always, you know, going from these tiny small cells like this, which I sell at my seed shop and they work, into a bigger container. As the plant grows, you can just start them in something about this size. And I'll show you the build. This is basil that's about 4 weeks old. Let's start with the foil trays. So you want to do this by simply tearing out a piece of the heavy duty foil and make it so that it's about square. It doesn't have to be perfect. You know, it didn't tear perfectly there. Don't worry about perfection. It's not really important. Plants don't care. So we're going to fold this over, and you just want to line the edges up the best that you can and then press it down. And you can see that it's not perfect. You're going to take the side, fold it once, whoops, fold it twice, and then you're going to do the same thing down here on the bottom. And this creates, you know, a really big container. That is too large. You can cut this into any size or shape that you want. I cut it right down the middle. You're going to fold this side up again. And then one more time. That just secures it. So you can make a larger container. You can make a smaller container. They're both going to work. And that's the essential design. Just follow the principles. It would open up and you would put your soil in there. At the end of the video, I'll show you how to fill these up because there's a specific way that you want to do it. After you have this done, you want to cut three cuts into here, making sure you're going, let's see if I can show this, past the fold into the foil. This is how the water is going to flow into there. So the hardest thing about this design was trying to figure out how to get it to stand upright. Because if you just did individual packs, they're gonna fall over, your dirt's gonna fall over. It's just gonna be a mess. This is not gonna move. So what you do is you just set these up. Let me start with the tape. Get a piece of tape. I like using the painter's tape. You want it to be, I don't know, something like that. And you're just gonna set it down. And you're going to put these on. See if I gave it enough tape. Nope, not long enough. So instead of throwing that away, we're just going to add a piece to it. And then three. And you want to leave a little bit of a gap. And you're just going to, this side, make sure it's in camera, this side can get folded down. This side, you're just bringing over here, you're kind of making the triangle. And then you're closing it. That's going to create a nice base. And then we would open these up. That's going to take a second. and you're just opening it up like that. Doesn't have to be perfectly round, doesn't have to be perfectly even going down. And then you take the flaps on the bottom and you bend them outward. Now, actually, in setting this up, I forgot to cut these, so we'll do it again. You want to put in three cuts. One, two, three. We're always good to water from the bottom. One, two, three. You get the idea. We're always good to water from the bottom. And you want water to drain out of here. One of the worst things that can happen is that you oversaturate your seed starts and the roots die off. And again, if you want to subscribe and follow me, every year, starting in January, I basically start my YouTube channel over and I start with videos on growing seed starts indoors. Now, of course, I have 1,800 videos. You can find them, but sometimes it's hard to search through all the videos on YouTube or on somebody's channel. So you can just watch in real time. I'm in Maryland Zone 7. So that's set up. It is solid. It's not going to fall over. We can put the soil in. Again, I'll do that at the end. And then this is a half-size baking tray. And you could fit in easily 9 of these. 9 tomato starts, pepper starts. You can move them around. You know, you could probably get 12 in here. Doesn't have to be perfect, but this is plenty of soil, really inexpensive and effective. And once you dump this out, you can actually close this up, you know, undo the tape, fold them over, and you could use them again next year. I used this last year. I like to, you know, kind of create, make things, whatever, in the garden. But I test stuff out for a good year or so before I make a video on it. But this is wonderful. The whole key, it's stable, lots of soil, you don't have to pot up, and you can grow just about anything you want in there. The water bottles are really no different than buying a bunch of these. Again, I sell these, but this is gonna save you a lot of money. You're just gonna cut the top off. Now, if you're too high, these are going to flop and fall over. So you want to get the right height. And, you know, I'm not even going to tell you if this is 4 inches, 5 inches, 3 inches. You know, something that works for you. You just want it to be stable. If you're growing like tomato plants or pepper plants or something that's going to be in or under your grow lights longer, maybe you want more space. I'll show you the quick cut, but you just want to get to the height you want. Say you want something smaller, you would just go right down the center. And there you go. Make sure you poke a hole in the bottom. The easiest way to poke a hole in these is to get a sharp knife or your scissors, and don't push the scissors, pull the plastic cup towards you. Takes a second, but it's a lot safer than trying to push, you know, something sharp and cutting yourself. Just pull the plastic towards you. Once the hole is in, I would probably do two, and you can start planting in it. The lower they are to the ground, the more stable they are. But again, I like to have more soil in there so you don't have to pot. The hardest thing was figuring out how to keep these stable. So just like we did, I'm going to show you two ways. Just like we did with the foil, you get a piece of tape, you put these down, put the tape down. And it's a lot easier to do it this way than to try and put them together and wrap it. So, and how do I know that? Because I spent quite a bit of time trying to figure this out. You could do the triangle, and you want a nice gap in between so that when you pull these together, they form a triangle. That's going to be stable enough, nothing's going to fall over. Now, maybe you want to do a six pack. So what you're going to do is just put them right next to each other, with about this much tape left over. It'll roll a little bit, but something like that. And then you're going to do the second six pack, or the second three, to make a six pack of containers to grow in. There's one. And you want to try and just line up the bottoms now so that they lay flat. And then once that's down, you're just going to place them on top of each other just like that. Make sure that they're nice and even. Tape down, tape down. And that's the easiest way to tape them together. and then you can just move these around, do what you want. All right, I'll show you how to fill these up too, because there's a little bit of a technique to it. But you get the idea. I mean, they fit perfectly right into the foil trays. That's going to hold 12. They're not going to fall over. Grow what you want. This is my seed starting mix, pre-moistened, hydrated with boiling water to kill off fungus gnats. And these are mosquito bits. These are another way to manage fungus gnats. Again, please subscribe. In January, I'll show you how to hydrate this with the hot water, talk more about fungus gnats. But now, I take a little bit of the mosquito bits. They kill off mosquitoes and fungus gnat larvae, and I just drop them in the bottom of my container, something like that. This is really fluffy. You don't want to plant into something this loose. So pack it down. You know, don't overly pack it, but just firm it in. This gives a great planting base. And that is perfect. You might see algae growing here because the sunlight's going to be hitting in here. The moisture's going to stay there. Algae's not going to hurt your plants. But this is just as good as anything you can buy. You can get the bottles for free, repurpose them. Saves you a lot of money. For the foil, now granted, it is kind of a funky shape. You're going to open up each compartment and you're going to do the same thing. Put in the mix and then really pack it down. You don't want it to be loose because the seeds will fall down a little bit deeper. Sometimes they have a problem germinating. Nice and firm. Fill it the rest of the way. Let me do these three. And of course, chatting away, I forgot to put the mosquito bits on the bottom of these, but I would just, you know, put maybe 10 of the little grains. All right, this is all set up, ready to grow. Nice solid base. And again, you can grow anything that you want in here. And it's enough soil that you're not gonna have to pot up your plants. And this is just, it's not gonna fall over. This is a really inexpensive way to grow plants indoors, create your own containers. Depending on how you get the materials, can be almost practically free. Thanks so much for watching. Please check out my seed shop at therustedgarden.com. Also check out my blog at therustedgardenblog.com. Again, grow just about anything you want in these type of containers. And just, you know, quick FYI, because there's holes in the bottom, I will just fill this container a little bit with water and the water will be wicked up from the bottom. Take care of the plants. This way you're not pouring water on top, you know, knocking possible fungus and molds around, knocking your seeds out. This is the easiest way to pour, and it's a pain to go over to each little cell in water. Just fill up the container. Your plants are good to go. Again, thanks for watching, and please subscribe.